Hello, everyone. I'm McKenzie Mitchell, and today I have the pleasure of sitting down with former NXT Tag Team Champs, Breezango. Thank you guys so much for being here. How are you?
So good.
Fantastic.
So good.
Great.
Got my white shoes on.
Great shoes.
Great. Well, me too. But every week we name the show. We don't technically have an official name for these sit-downs, but with Bronson Reed, it was
Apron Hangs.
With Ever-Rise, it was
Hot and Loud.
With Jake Atlas, it was
What's Tea.
Dakota Kai, it was
The Mac and Dak Attack.
Then we go to Leon Ruff, and it was
A Ring Time with Ruff.
Then we go to Mercedes Martinez, and she didn't really have a name for the show. No, we don't do that. No. And then last week, with Shotzi Blackheart, it was
McKenzie Mitchell's massive, mighty party interview.
So what are we naming the show today?
I know, he's probably already got one.
The One Take Wonders, the story of Fandango and Tyler Breeze.
Featuring Breeze.
We really just needed one, but...
Talking smart with Breezango. Yeah.
You opened it up.
All of them.
You don't even have a name for your show. Simon. You gave it to him. He's gonna go off like this.
Well, we have a few names then.
Now you got a million of them.
Can name. So
the
great.
The Breezango Hour.
Nice. The Breezango Hour. I like that. Yeah. Great. Okay. Well, we learned last Wednesday that obviously the NXT Tag Team titles are currently vacated. Mm-hmm. And at TakeOver Stand and Deliver, it will be a triple threat. MSK, Gross of Young Veterans, as well as Legado del Fantasma. Mm. Who do you think will walk away as the NXT Tag Team champs in this match?
Who do you think?
I mean, that's tough. I don't know. You know, because I mean, we've... Obviously, we've had our quarrels with Legado, actually, you know, Grizzled Young too. But MSK is kind of the mystery.
They're kind of the wild card,
a
the unknown.
Bit. We have no clue. We've never wrestled them.
Yeah, we said hi to them.
Brief interaction.
We danced in the ring with them a couple weeks ago.
Dance party with them. That was you.
But kind of new to NXT. Obviously, a huge upside. A lot of talent. Young guys.
They're hungry.
They're hungry.
I think I'm gonna go with MSK.
I'm gonna go with MSK too.
MSK?
Really?
Across the board.
The newcomers here.
What does MSK stand for? Mean Street Clowns with a K?
Mean Street Clown, yeah, you got
mean
it.
Mean Street Clowns?
That's it.
Do you know what it stands for?
I actually don't know. I think that's Machine a question
Gun
we could ask them eventually,
Kelly?
Right? Probably not.
Machine Sun Kelly.
I'm sure that's copyrighted.
What do you think it stands for? Do we know?
I kind of like the Mean Street Clowns. That was
mean
cool.
Street Clowns.
Yeah.
Well, you guys could ask them, right?
Pete Gass,
next time
manager.
You dance around them.
Joey Abs.
Yeah. Joey Abs. Pete Gass.
Shane. We'll ask them next time. We'll get back to you.
Next
the whole
time.
Gang.
Cool. Okay, so that brings me to my next point. Every time you guys come out to the ring, it seems like Fandango is always the one that's dancing.
That's
why
right.
Are you never dancing, Breeze?
Well,
yeah, Breeze.
If you, first off,
why are you never dancing?
Nobody's ever said that.
It's because you're the model and I'm the dancer, right?
That's exactly it. So the whole point is if you've done your research,
how many times have we gone to the ring and got to the back and like, why weren't you both dancing? And then you're like, I don't know if you guys ever knew, like, I'm not a dancer. I'm a model, yeah. Right?
Can you show us your dance skills today?
I sure can't. So
why are you trying to call him out and put him on the spot? We're live.
10 years here, I've never once danced. He dances all the time. Dancer, model, that's why it goes together.
Four months, can you get the camera on me? 4 months of dance school, and this is all I got out of it.
Wow.
That's great, though.
I'm sorry, sir.
That's great.
Okay, so can you strike a pose then? I guess that's how it works.
Hold on.
We're live.
No, we're not. And secondly, this-
He just said we were live. Are we live or are we not live?
You don't know what he's saying. We're not just like this little like board here that you can just press a button and go, dance for me.
That's my
pose
thing.
For me.
That's my
Doesn't
thing.
Work that way.
Okay, so you guys have been with NXT since really the beginning.
That's
You've seen
right.
the evolution of NXT. How have you seen things grow from where it was to where it is now?
No more keg carry.
Yeah.
Keg carry. What is keg carry?
Like hot dog eating contests.
So just do me a favor. Go on YouTube and just type in Titus O'Neil keg carry.
Yeah.
Okay.
You'll know all you need to know.
Get out
is
here
that Titus?
Jungle.
Are we pulling this up right at this moment?
Yeah, we are.
He is huge.
12.7 seconds, the time to beat. Are you ready? Set, go get him.
I think he threw some kegs around at the University of Florida.
Oh!
Let's see.
Oh!
You know what? If you're not going to win it, my thing is, if you're not going to win the Royal Rumble, think of a cool way to get eliminated. And Titus always thinks of a cool way, a memorable way.
We're not watching anyone else carry the keg right now. We're watching Titus because he thinks he did that on purpose. He's a clever guy.
Nobody wants to see someone carry the keg around.
No,
they
want to
see
you fall.
Disaster. That's what I want to see.
Clever.
What was your favorite time in WWE throughout the years?
I think when we first started in the Fashion Police, man, that was some of the funnest times when we were doing the files and stuff. I think it really opened up us having a little bit more personality, you know? So that was probably the funnest time that I've had in WWE.
When you're a tag team, obviously, you need to mesh. And I think like once we started kind of having fun and doing that, every week was like fun. And even like including the Ascension and stuff like that, like we were going, it was fun every single week.
So tell me, how do you guys adapt to all of these different personalities? One week you're an astronaut, the next week you're what, a lumberjack? Like you have all these different personalities that come out weekly on NXT TV. How do you adapt to that?
You just gotta commit.
It's a gift that, you know, you can't really teach people it. It's called it.
Some people have the it factor. Yeah.
Or they don't, and you can't really teach it, you know what I'm saying? So fortunately for me, I was born with it.
And what about you, Breeze? Do you have it?
I do. Not as much as Dango.
He's the brains of the operation. And I'm not the brains of the operation.
But you just do it, what he says. Okay.
Yeah. This is what happens. I'm like, have you ever gone bowling with like the bumpers?
Right.
So he's the bowling ball wildly out of control thrown by a 5-year-old, and I'm the bumpers keeping us where we need to go.
Okay, very good analogy there. Okay, well, it's been awesome and certainly fun here with you guys today. Thanks so much for joining me on the Breezango Hour. That's
right.
What it's called now.
No,
Featuring
Breeze.
Where'd you come up with that?
All right. Okay, well, thanks again, guys. We love watching you on Wednesdays on NXT. Keep it up.
It's the hot minute with Breezango.
Featuring Breeze.
Yeah. Out. Oh.